My name is Steven Carpenter. I teach green energy engineering and physics at Avenues. The primary goal of the class is to teach the students the engineering design process and get them to think about problem solving in a different way. The students are developing wind turbines, and they're a couple days into prototyping different blade designs right now.
Our group decided that we should try and test different materials. So we've had from balsa wood to plastic cardboard to Tyvek tape. We tried all of them, and we've tried to see which one's more efficient.
They've already brainstormed and put ideas on paper. They've presented ideas to their class, and then based on the presentations, they grouped themselves into groups that had similar ideas. From there, they had to build. They got out the balsa wood, the cardboard, the X-Acto knives, and started cutting and gluing until they had their first design. And then it was time to test the blades out for the first time.
Yeah. Why?
The first couple attempts at testing were riddled with errors, which I think got the kids to think about how important it is to consistently test a design the same way every time. So after we ironed out those wrinkles, they decided that the turbine should be 1 meter from the fan, and the fan should be turned on level 3 every time, and that is hooked up to a software called Logger Pro. The software measures the voltage and the current coming out of the turbine and does some calculations to find the power output.
So it's 0.002556.
That's amazing.
Yeah. That's pretty good.
So let me show you. It's a lot of math. Let me show you the calculations we had to do. So see, the efficiency is the electrical power over wind power times 100%. And to find electrical power times voltage by current, and that is done by the computer. But what we do have to do is find the density of air and then the wind speed of the fan and then plug those in to the equation.
Immediately, they're going to be presenting their conclusions from these little mini experiments that they ran.
So what we did was we tested different materials, and we also tested two different shapes to make sure our result was actually the material making a difference and not the blade shape.
So some groups decided to change their angles around, some groups decided to try out different materials, and they'll share those results with the class, and then the process will move forward from there.
So next, after we have a definite measure of which one's most efficient, we're going to go around the school and find objects that we could use. For example, the rowing machine upstairs in the fitness room. We're going to try and make it so that when you pull it, it generates some kind of electricity somehow. We're not sure how we're going to do that yet, but we're going to try and see.
The whole point of a green energy class isn't necessarily that they become experts in green energy. It's that they develop the engineering practices. If the students come out of the class with just a good understanding of that process, they'll be prepared to go into another engineering course or apply that process in writing or solving math problems. The idea that you don't have to get it right the first time, but your first try is just that, it's your first try, and that you should be improving your solutions over time.
I'm paying more close attention to detail after doing this because we've been, you know, changing every variable of the turbine, the angle, the shape, the thickness, the material, like every little thing added up in the end, and now we're making our final design, so it all paid off.
I haven't had a class that combined physics and math and creativity, and it's just really nice to be in a place where all of these concepts are combined to produce something that will actually help the school become more energy efficient. Even though it's going to be a small amount, we're probably going to light a light bulb, but it's still going to be an accomplishment that I'm sure all of us will be proud of and happy to tell our friends about. You know.